come down, 5, 6 are 30, okay, then 2 minus 0, 2, 3 minus 3, 0, 5 will come down, 5, 5 are 25, okay, so 5 minus 5 is 0, 2 minus 2, 0, so what we will get here, 1 and then 65, okay, that numerator.
Okay, so here we are multiplying by 125. So here also we have to multiply by 125.
Now what will divided by 2. 4 is also divided by 2. So 2 2s are 4. 2 2s are 4. 2 8s are 16. See, when we divide for 456 by 2, we got 228. 100 divided by 2, see, 2 5s are 10. 2 6s are 10. Again, now see, here we got petmols plus 8. Here we got 0. Okay, so now again both the numbers are divisible by 2. So again divide by 2 for both the numbers. Okay, now see what we get. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. Now what we get here? 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. So what we got answer here now? 140 upon 25. 140 upon 25. Now again these numbers are divisible by 2. No. Then you check, is it divisible by 2? It is divisible. Both the numbers are divisible by 3 or not. Then 4 or not. This way you can check and you can solve. See, as both the numbers are not divisible by with any same number. So what is the answer? 140 upon 25. Okay. Now next example, 0.04. Now 0.04. See here, 0.04. So what will write here now? Only 4. Even if you write 004, 004 means only 4. Okay, upon, now after one, how many zeros we have to give? See, every decimal will not come 100 only. See here, after decimal point, here one digit. So here we give after one 0. Here after decimal point, there are two digits. So here we give after one 2 zeros. Similarly, here also see now, after decimal point, how many digits are given? 2 digits. So here after one give 2 zeros. So now what we got here? 4 upon 100. 4 upon 100. Now 4 is even number. Okay, and here at one specific 0. So both the numbers are divisible by 2. Okay, so divide by 2 for numerator as well as denominator. So 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10, 2 0s are 0. Again, now 2 and C. These both the numbers are divisible by 2 or not? Yes. So again divide by 2. So what will we get? 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. See, 50 divided by 2, what will we get? 25. So what is the answer? 1 upon 25. So first what we have to do, we have to convert this decimal number into fraction and then it's reduced term. Okay. Let's solve question number 2. Convert the following fractions into decimals. Okay. Now see, these are the given fractions and we have to convert into decimal. So I explain you easy method. When we divide by 10, 100, 1000 or 10,000, okay, that time what we have to do, we have to count the number of zeros and shift the decimal point from right towards left. Okay, now see here, 258 upon 1000 divided by 1000 means how many number of zeros are here? 3. Dividing by 1000 means obviously number of zeros are 3. So 3 digits we have to shift. We have to shift the digits from right towards left. See. So how many number of zeros are here? 3. After one there are 3 zeros here. Okay. So 3 digits we have to shift from right towards left. So 258. Number of zeros 3. See. 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. 3 digits we have to shift from right towards left. Don't count from here, left to right. We have to count the number of digits from right towards left. Okay. And here give 0. So 0.258. Or you can write only 0.258. That is also correct. 0.258 or 0.258. Both are correct. Okay, so what is the answer? 0.258. Now here 13 upon 100. Now see here divided by 100. 13 divided by 100. Divided by 100. So how many number of zeros are here? 2 zeros are here. So how many digits we have to shift from right towards left? 2 digits. Okay, so write numerator number as it is. See what is the number at numerator place? 30. So write as it is. Number of zeros, count the number of zeros, 2. So 1, 2. Shift the decimal point from right towards left. Count the number of digits and write the decimal point. Okay. So here you become 0.13. Here you can write 0 or only 0.13 also you can write. So what is the answer? 0. 0.13. Now let's see next example. 16 upon 10. Okay. So what we have to convert into decimal? This number we have to convert into decimal. Okay. This is given number is in fraction. We have to convert into decimal. So first write numeric number as it is. Then what I said after that? See, it is divided by 10. Means how many number of zeros are here? 4 only. Yes, 1 0 is there. Okay, so shift the digit, one digit from right towards left. See, 1. So here it will come decimal point here. See, 1 0. So from right come the digit 1 digit. So before 1 digit, give the decimal. Okay, so what is the answer? 1.6. So what is the answer? 1.6. Okay, now in this example, if you will say 23 upon 10,000, it is given as 23 divided by 10,000. Okay, so what I say, when we convert fraction into decimal, right, you will just number as it is first. Okay, then now say zeros, how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros, so count the digit 1, 2. Now you will say that 4 numbers are not there, then what to do? Then we have to write our zeros here. Okay, see, 1 2 3 4, 4 digit we have to shift. So count from right towards left. 1 2, now third number is not there, so 0. Fourth number is also 0. See, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4. So before this 0 we have to leave the decimal part. So what is the answer? 0.0023. See what I did. First, what we have to write 23 as it is. Okay. Then count the number of zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros are there, so we have to shift the digit from right towards left, 4 digit. Okay. So, but here only 2 digits are there. So what we did, we have to write our whole 0, 0. We have to shift 4 digits. Nah? So make 4 digits here. But we have to write towards left, not this side. We have to increase the zeros. See. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then give the decimal point. We have it 0. So 0.0023 or only 0.0023 also you can write.